as we were saying, Java EE, you're not going to have that. You're not going to have database development. Those are stuff that I've installed over time. One of the great things about Eclipse is that you can actually install other stuff. So you'll see that I have a little bit of Android tools here and Amazon Web Services tools and PHP tools. And you know, all that's good. What you guys should be thinking about right now, now that you have Eclipse running, is you want to go ahead and make a new Java project. And let's talk about this. Let's call this opening project 2016. And sometimes if you have a lot of projects, or even for you guys, you should give your project a descriptive name so that you feel like by looking at the project, you know what it's about. Don't call it my project, you know, or you know, give it some descriptiveness. And so let's, but I do want to give you guys a single project that you work on for the entire term. So you're not creating thousands of little projects, but rather you're creating a big project. So let's call this the term project for 2016. And what this does by the default location, if you take a look inside of this, this is actually going to save into what's called the default workspace. Now, it doesn't matter if you're on a Mac or Windows. Basically, Eclipse is going to go down into what's called a workspace. And if you're on Windows, it's going to be my document slash workspace. If you're on Mac, it's going to be, you know, your home directory documents workspace. And you'll find that inside of your workspace is going to be all of your various projects. Now, what's cool about that is that if you're a Dropbox person, what you can do is you could take the entire workspace and you could copy it to your Dropbox, or you could even make the workspace inside of Dropbox. What's nice about that is the moment that you have made something, it will automatically back itself up to the cloud. So you'll never carry a flash drive around. That could be interesting to you guys. Now, what I want to do is I want to actually make this in a unique position by putting that inside of our GitHub folder. And this 234 is just the current class that I'm instructing for. And what I'd like to do is just put a new folder here, which is going to be called my term project. You know, depending upon where that's located. And if that's going to work out, so you can see how that's been placed there. And that's not going to be my default location. But if you want to put it in your default location, that's going to work great. It's going to work great for you guys. So I'm going to go next, next your way through it. Now, some things that are happening right here, this is going to be what's called my source folder. My source folder is where I'm going to put my source code. My source code is the stuff that I'm going to write into Eclipse. So if I use the word source code with you guys, it's because I'm talking about the code that you've written in class. That's going to be your source code. So naturally, it's going to be located under SRC for source. Now, libraries, you're going to use the JRE. You know, these are other libraries that you're going to use in a very generic, basic Java program. And that's all you need for this class. Now, if you go forward with other kinds of classes, like in web or Android or you know other types of Java, you may have other libraries that you're going to use. So we'll talk more as we go with that. So I'm going to finish. And that's going to create a new project. It's called Term Project. Now, within Eclipse, what you're going to have is several views. And you can also have various perspectives related to what you're trying to make. And so this Windows is going to be quite valuable to you. So I'm going to go Show View. Now, I'm going to go into the Project Explorer side over here. I can also go to the Navigator. And it's going to open up all the various projects that I have. Now, I believe that I've made, and I got to kind of remember what my project was called. And it's actually called Term Project. And so I'm going to go in there. And I want to go into my Project Explorer, which gives me a little bit better view that I can open up and I can see what I've made. Now what's happening here is I'm going to say, I want to go up to source and I want to go right click on it and I want to say a new class. Now, just a word on this. Everything that we write here inside of Java is going to be what's called a class. And so you guys should get used to this notion of a class. And let's talk about what a class is. Now, inside of every project, we have what's called a main. Now, the main is the most important file that you make inside of the project because it's kind of like the brain center. And it's the piece of the project that Eclipse compiles first. So if you want for Eclipse to do something, you better tell Eclipse about it inside of the main. So the main is the first thing that we're going to make this evening in order to make our first project work. And so I'm going to call this my brain center. And that I'm going to use just as a way to teach the relevance of the main. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to call it brain center, and then I'm going to go finish. Now what's happened is inside of my source, I now have a little file called brain center .java. And you notice that there's really nothing happening inside of it just yet. But there is what's called a main. Now the main is what's called the primary compilation unit. The main is called, it's really the main compilation because it runs first. And so if you type something inside of main, then it's going to happen inside of the project. So everything I type here is going to happen. Hi, this just happened. And you notice I'm doing a lot of typing there, system out, print line. That's quite a lot of busyness. But when I compile that, that's just going to write a little bit, and that wants me to, hi, this just happened. That's just going to print a little bit to the screen there. Now this area, and I know I'm moving fast, but this is going to be a YouTube, so you can always stop it, move it slow, right? So I'm going to go fast because it's going to be recorded. But you can see this is what's called the console. Everything that we do inside of this class is going to appear inside of the console. So there won't be any windows. There won't be any graphics. It'll just be stuff moving inside the console, and you will find yourself fascinated with it. It's one of the cool things about working with computers. So if I can also terminate it, and that empties it, and I can also delete it. Now I can also bring it back by saying, hi, I'd like to show the view of the console. Now the console is incredibly valuable, so even if you close it, maybe you want to open it back up, and it'll go back to that output that it had there. Now I happen to terminate it, so it doesn't have anything. But I can press that go button right here. Now I happen to have billions and billions of little projects that I work on. Some of them are going nowhere. Some of them are literally, you know, money in the bank. They're all mixed together in this big soup. So there's actually a log of other mains that are happening here. But I want that brain center. So I select that, and when I press my go button, it's going to execute that program. Pretty good. So that's the relevance here. And I'm going to stop the video in just a second because I want to keep it under the 15-minute limit. But what you want to think about is in this first project, you just want to be thinking about what's happening inside of the main. And that's going to be really important to us. But I want to just lead into the next project by saying that in this class, we're going to make a gigantic digital stock market. Many of you you've heard of the stock market, you've discussed the stock market, maybe it's something that you follow, but we're going to actually create a stock market here. The stock market is just a big, gigantic program. And that's all it is. And people order stuff from the market, and they sell stuff on the market, and the order processes the entire economy in one application. So we want to say, wow, programmers built the stock market. I wonder how that's possible. And so we want to use that MIT method by trying to see how something is possible by trying to make one of our own, right? And I wanted to give you guys a lot of confidence that programmers really are important people and that you guys are part of that tribe. Okay, so we're going to go after a really interesting problem in this class, which I'm going to explain. But let's just say this. A stock market is built of many stocks. So what we want to think about first is we want to create an object or something that kind of represents a little digital stock that's happening. And so in our next little video, we're going to go over how to make objects to get Java up and running.